We are at the Pinkpop Festival in the south of Holland.
We started the first festival in 1970 with 10,000 people, with only a ticket price for €1. I'm now here for 29 years, and since we're here, we're growing and growing and growing. The maximum people that is allowed to ticket is 70,000.
Pinkpop is definitely one of the best organised, and everything is very well thought out. It's set up in a very conscientious way. It's nice. It's a nice festival to work at, and it's definitely in the kind of top end of the festivals. All the crew guys like working at.
Well, so here on the Pinkpop we have four hangs, all completely similar. The mains and the outs, all 18 E15s with four E12 underhangs. Front of house is split, so we're not in the middle, as you probably can see from this position. Main bit is all open, and to mix from this position is actually no problem for anyone, because the overall coverage is so even.
I prefer being up center. There's hardly anybody in the center. Nearly everybody's on the sides, so it makes no sense to be in the middle, really. It's better to be representative of where the people are, really.
As every engineer knows, if you're on a festival and you enter your front of house tent, you always have to deal with this plastic shit. Gerard Kuster made a special roof for me, an inside roof, make it a very comfortable front of house tent to mix in, so that if you step outside and inside, the difference is reduced a lot.
It was, from the first moment, noticeable that the Adamson boys have been achieving something new than what existed till now. And I'm talking especially from mids to tops. That's where it all became way smoother than the rest.
It's a real nice system to work with, that you reel it in and then, yeah, hook it up, hoist it up, and then you're pretty much ready to go. So exactly the same system was running last Wednesday for Iron Maiden in the Gelre Dome, and then overnight we brought it here and we started on Thursday, and we started at 9 a.m. and then at 12 all PA was hanging and running, so that's pretty cool.
The amazing thing about the PA is that it didn't change much, even after it was like, it was honest, it was clear, and then the definition was still there even with bodies. It didn't lose any of that when you had a sea of 10,000 people soaking up high mids and stuff like that. Pretty much make sure my mix is very vocal, present, audible, clear, and that is insanely hard to accomplish with a PA that doesn't have proper efficiency, clarity, like no separation between drivers. You just will lose a vocal in a bad system set up on a PA.
I really enjoyed the clarity of the system, and a nice big warm sound was great. I felt it sounded really good.
It was great. It sounded nice. It was easy to work with. There was no problems at all for me.
Yeah, it makes my life beautiful. It's all about smoothness. There's no pots that pump out that you do here in other systems, also very good ones. This one is smoother, 100%.
It's one of those boxes that's just clear and honest, and when you have a good system tech, you can run it almost open on a flat graph. Like it's a box that was designed so well. If it's handled and set up properly, it just makes you look like such a superhero.
A well-tuned PA in the right position doesn't make me a magician, you know? I just retransfer what's happening on stage.
One is a little better in this, the other is a little better in that, and it's a matter of taste as well. But I think it's a technically well-built box. What does the job, and I like it.
It is amazing to go halfway around the world and then show up and you're like, oh, I drove by that going to my friend's cottage when I was 14 years old. And that's what people on the other side of the world choose is the best. It's not a German or an English company, it's a Canadian one.